Hi everyone, welcome to Straight from the Divine Tarot. We're now ready to do the sign for Gemini, the first week of April 2022. If you like the video, like, share, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you know when I next upload. Welcome to my soul family, my soul tribe. You're most welcome here. This is also for cross watchers as well. I keep forgetting to say that, but yeah. I don't go by signs and I don't go by gender. I go by the energies. It's less confusing that way. I might use the pronouns he, she only because that's what's on the card. But if you bear with me, it'll be less confusing that way. And don't try to fit anything that doesn't fit in your life. You know your own story. Take what applies, leave the rest. There's so many people out there. It's not always all for us all at once, right? Like I said, some of it might apply, some of it won't. So let's see where we go. Spirit guides, guardian angels, ancestors of the white light, what do you have for the sign of Gemini the first week of April 2022? What can we expect for the first week of April, please, spirit guides? Let's go. Here we go. Okay, so we have the star in reverse. Somebody's feeling hopeless, maybe. Could be ill. They don't have faith in a situation or person anymore. No wish fulfillment. It could be blocking their own abundance here. It could be shame as well. Bottom of the deck, we have the Two of Swords in the upright. Somebody's unable to make a decision. They could be in denial about a situation, very conflicted. Could be blocked from something or someone. Star in the reverse, the sign of Gemini, thank you. We have the Three of Pentacles in the reverse. Could be ending of a contract, a false contract. It could be ending of a third party situation or collaboration. Working by oneself. Somebody didn't put the work in. They were too lazy. They could be very disrespectful. So yeah, if you're working with somebody like that, I could see why you're losing hope or you don't have no faith in this person's abilities to either, do a job or complete something with you. There's just no cohesion here. Six of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. This is giving and receiving, balancing out the scales, being fair, generosity, and even give and take, equally yoked. Maybe you thought you were equally yoked and it's not working out that way. Let's see. Please clarify, spirit guides, guardian angels, ancestors of the white light. Please clarify the star in the reverse and the Three Pentacles in the reverse, please. The sun in Gemini, first week of April 2022. All right, we got King of Wands in reverse. Could be very angry. Very angry, egotistical, a tyrant, conceited, hasty, not fit for a position. Doesn't have the right qualifications. Could have lied about their qualifications. They could have had, stars in their eyes type of thing. It looked great in the beginning. And then, stars falling here. The truth is coming out. This person's not qualified. Not qualified at all for whatever they're in a position for. Six of Swords in reverse, unable to move forward here, unable to keep going. This could be trouble looming. There's a blockage of some sort, mental blockage. Bottom of the deck, Ten of Wands. Somebody's out to prove something, but it's a burden. Maybe trying to prove that they can do this job if it's work related, or they're good for this role or this part. But yeah, it's just so burdensome here. It's an ending. Tens indicate a cycle ending. So something's ending for sure. This can't go on any further. They can't go any further. Six of Swords in the reverse for the sign of Gemini, please. Thank you. Yeah. Could be a gold digger or a clout chaser. Somebody chases after people of value or positions of value. It's not theirs, maybe. They're seizing an opportunity, maybe, to get rid of this person. I don't know. We'll see where this goes. Yeah, somebody's out in their ass. So they're seizing an opportunity to put somebody out. They're out in the cold. Out of lack. No confidence, maybe. Or it could be, in politics, no confidence vote. It could be that, too. Who knows, right? There's just no confidence in this person anymore. Four of Cups in reverse. Sun in Gemini. First week of April 2022, please. If there's any elections around your area, maybe that's it too, right? Yeah, so somebody, Seven of Swords in reverse. Somebody can't go any further. Maybe somebody got caught doing something and they came clean. That could also mean that too. Maybe somebody thought that they'd forever be, you know, in a position and they'd never have to come clean about anything, never be stopped. Four of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. Yeah, holding back here. They've grown attached to something, maybe. Greedy, selfish, trying to protect oneself, not wanting to let go, maybe not wanting to let go of the position. Maybe, you know, going to HR, fighting, battling this out in court. Who knows? Seven of Swords in the reverse. I don't see any love so far, so Gemini. Yeah, somebody wants to come in from out of the cold. This could mean a big drop in finances, a big loss, financial loss. Wanting to recoup something. But I really think that, yeah, they're going to have to. Somebody got caught doing something maybe at work. It's a big financial loss for them, yeah. This is the Hierophant reverse. This is a higher power. Somebody got some bad advice maybe. You know, maybe it's they don't want to go to court. Maybe they're going to try to settle this outside of court, recoup their losses, right? Maybe they'll lose more in court. Who knows what this is? It's a separation of sorts, that's for sure. Five of Pentacles. Why is this here, please, in the reverse? Five of Pentacles, please, Spirit. Thank you. We have Two of Pentacles in the upright. So somebody's weighing their options. Head over heart decision. Trying to keep things in balance. And alignment. Maybe needing some more clarity upon a situation. Could be juggling money, people. Bottom of the deck. There is a decision that needs to be made. It's the Lovers, but it doesn't necessarily have to be about love. It could be just a decision. There's consequences for whatever decision is made. This is a card of consequence. If it is Lovers, then somebody has the choice of two, right? That's the bottom of the deck. Maybe somebody's vying for a position and there's a choice of two. And one's not making the cut. Who knows? Two of Pentacles in the upright, please. There's Two of Pentacles in the upright. Or maybe somebody got sacked and they have a choice of two now. Four of Pentacles in the reverse now. Somebody's letting go. Opening up, possibly. Letting go of this attachment. Not serving them well. This is the High Priestess in reverse. Somebody's not... Didn't use her intuition. There was a lack of awareness, maybe. Maybe somebody didn't see it coming that they were going to get sacked. It could be a lot of shit talking, though. There could have been a lot of shit talking. If it's a place of employment, they crossed the line there, you know. It's nothing worse than a gossip at work or a shit talker, troublemaker, right? It could also be somebody's coming out and speaking their truth. Or they can just, yeah, have some few parting words before they walk away. Walking away from an investment here, right? No emotional fulfillment or happiness. So, yeah, maybe they told them where to go. Choice words. Why is the High Priestess in the reverse here, please? Sign of Gemini, please. I hear contentious. I just heard that word in my head. So, whatever this is, it's very contentious. High Priestess in reverse, please. So somebody's letting go of this shit talker. Or they're opening up and letting them have it. I don't know. Yeah, Six of Cups in reverse. Just regrets here. Huh. Unable to reconcile this. It's not happy. Not happy. No happy memories here. Could be some trauma. I mean, maybe if it's a poison atmosphere at work, somebody's been traumatized. I mean, that does happen. Bottom of the deck, we have Page of Swords in the upright. So maybe somebody's looking into it. They could be investigating a situation, watching carefully, closely watching somebody. Right? mean, if something's happened at work and somebody's been accused of something, or they're doing something that's not right, yeah, the employer would definitely be watching very closely. Six of Cups in the reverse for the sign of Gemini, please. Thank you. Yeah, something's now over. It's permanent. It's profound. It can't be revived again. It's done. Whatever this is. I don't see any love. I don't see a relationship here, but somebody's going to be very emotional. Very emotional. Something's done. It hurts. I mean, it doesn't matter who you are. When you lose a job for whatever reason, it's always sad, right? If it's job related, it could be friend related. I don't know what this is. You know your story. Death in the reverse, please, Spirit. Why is this here for the sign of Gemini? Missed opportunity, squandered funds. They squandered their opportunity, possibly. If it's somebody that wasn't qualified for this job and maybe bullshitted their way through it, they could have wasted a lot of money, right? Could have maybe talked shit about somebody behind their back, and that's how they got the position. And this position was a blessing to somebody. It was somebody else's blessing. Now the blessing's being taken away because somebody might have taken their blessing. Could have stolen money at work as well. Somebody's being released. Eight of Swords in reverse. They've been released. They're removing the obstacles. Letting go. Let it go. Let it go. And so Pentacles in the reverse with the sign of Gemini, please. Could be an insurance claim here. Death. They didn't collect on a death. They can't collect on a death, maybe, of a child. What the heck? That's a different story. Yeah. Or maybe they lied. This is shit talker, right? Saying that a child died or something like that. It's been some trauma that caused a death, and, you know, it was for insurance money, trying to block somebody from receiving their insurance money. Who knows? Ace of Pentacles in reverse with the sign of Gemini. Somebody's, wherever they are, they're not happy. They're pretending they're happy. There's no emotional fulfillment or happiness here. None whatsoever. Could be squandered their time here. I don't know. This is disjointed. I don't know if this makes any sense to you guys. I hope it does. Five of Swords in reverse. Yeah, somebody's feeling disgraced, embarrassed, maybe. They just want to put this whole episode behind them. Maybe somebody is holding a grudge against somebody. You know? Maybe they thought that once they leave this company, they'll get a separation package or something. They're not getting jack shit here. They squandered their resources. I don't know. Let's see. Eight of Cups in reverse with the sign of Gemini, please. Why is this here? What is this Ace of Pentacles in the reverse? Eight of Cups in reverse. Thank you. Huh. Maybe this person partied too much. It could be a collaboration with other people. See where this goes. Bottom of the deck. Speaking truth. So this could be friends, peers, co-workers speaking the truth about a situation. Speaking the truth to this Queen of Swords. Maybe she's an employer, HR person, an investigator of some sort, a lawyer. Speaking their truth, right? She's got a discerning eye, a discerning ear. She's very wise, intelligent, and intuitive. So, yeah. Three cups in the upright for the sign of Gemini, please. Thank you. Yeah, there's some bad news here. Page of Wands in reverse. Some bad news coming. Somebody was lying. Rumor, gossip, slander, whatever. They lied about their resume, lied about their credentials. I don't know what this is. Felt very, it's an entitled energy. I'm very entitled. They strip a lot of shit. There's drama, drama, drama. They love drama to deflect away from themselves, right? They cause drama amongst their co-workers or their friends or their whatever group this is. You know, Gemini, yeah, that's truth, right? Queen of Swords in the upright, that's the truth. Somebody's getting cut out. Why is the Page of Wands here in reverse, please? It's very juvenile person. Could be a young person, not yet learned lessons in life yet. I don't know. This is the Fool in reverse. Very reckless, careless, foolish. They take unnecessary risks. They're naive, or they think other people are naive, right? They take a lot of risks. They really come close to the edge type of thing, you know? Very disloyal, very, very, that dog in the upright, dogs mean loyalty. This person's very disloyal. Very. Can't trust this person, yeah. Devil energy, bottom of the deck. There's obsessions, addictions, codependency, temptation, greed, jealousy. I don't know what it is. This person's got codependency problems. Personality problems, put it that way. Why is the Fool in reverse here for the sign of Gemini? I'm gonna wind down here. That's 1606. Okay, so why is this Fool in reverse, Spirit? Let's clarify. Okay. So yeah, somebody's stuck in their head, maybe. She could be going to jail. Whatever this person's feeling restricted, mentally restricted. This is self-imposed, by the way. She could always stand up and walk away. If it's mentally stuck. Maybe they wanted to keep somebody stuck in their head, playing all these games, right? All these lies. So this is the Lovers now in the reverse. It's come back out again, but in the reverse. So this is poor judgment. Making the wrong choice. So if they hired somebody above another, if there's two choices, they made the wrong choice and they now know it. It's poor judgment on somebody's part. This, again, is a card of consequence, right? Bottom of the deck, yeah. Somebody has no integrity, loyalty, or honesty. Harsh judgment. A lot of ego and pride here. And last card, why the Lovers in reverse, please? It's a separation, for sure. Thank you, Spirit. Yeah, the Queen of Swords, she's come out three times. She knows the truth. She's going to speak her truth. She's going to allow you to speak yours too, but do not fuck around. She knows the score. She knows the truth. You screw around, she's going to cut you right out. She doesn't suffer fools gladly, like I said. She's very discerning, very smart. So, Gemini, that's what we have for you for the first week of April. I was hoping that would be better news. I mean, it doesn't look like it's love. It could very well be. It's just very, you know, maybe it's a very cold relationship. But let's see. You know your story. Spirit guides, guardian angels, ancestors, the white light. What are your messages? What is your advice for Gemini first week of April 2022? Please, thank you. Flexible in reverse, card number 19. So that is the Sun in reverse in tarot. Not happy, not healthy. There's the book. In the dark about something, needing clarity. Take what applies here. 19, where are you, 19? 11. Okay, just sit. Bear with me, please. And since it's upside down, I'm just going to read the protection message. When you or someone else becomes too rigid, you lose the access. You lose the access to growth and untapped potential, and find yourself in an us versus them scenario. So maybe somebody wanted all the glory for themselves in this work area, if it's work. Loosen up, open your mind and heart, and see if a more flexible approach feels better. Rigidity will set you up for a fight where there are only losers and no winners. Could you find a way to bring about a result that's mutually beneficial? Meet in the middle. Spirit makes a great mediator. Maybe you own a business with somebody that's like that. I don't know. Well, hopefully you like the read, Gemini, and hopefully it helps. Let me know. I'm dying to know if this is reaching people, if it's actually connecting, if people are resonating. Like I said, I just started this channel. I would like some feedback, if you don't mind. Some likes, too, would be nice. So until next time, Gemini, take care.